Hello everyone, welcome in a Rose Project. Myself Patil AS from SGM College, Karad. At a previous lecture, we completed colligative properties of a non-electrolyte solution, and from four colligative properties, we completed two colligative properties, that means vapor pressure lowering and boiling point elevation. In this lecture, we start remaining two colligative properties, that means freezing point of a depression and osmotic pressure. First, recall something. What is mean freezing point? Up to 10th class, we know that the freezing point means the temperature at which the liquid is converted into the solid. That means changing of a phase. Liquid to solid, at which temperature is the freezing point. But actual definition of the freezing point is, freezing point of a liquid is the temperature at which liquid and solid both are in equilibrium and two phases have the same vapor pressure. That liquid and solid both are in equilibrium as well as both have same vapor pressure. Depression in a freezing point, how the freezing point will be depressed? See here, in a container, if we take a pure solvent or a pure liquid, that pure liquid is our solvent. Every molecule present on the surface of this solvent having vapor pressure. See here, every molecule having vapor pressure on that. That vapor pressure of the solvent is a P1 naught. If we prepare the solution, that means the solute is taken into a beaker, and if we add into that a solute, that the solvent molecules present on the surface will be reduces by the solute molecule. If we adding a solute into that, which solute we add? The solute which is added into the solution, that solute be non-volatile and non-ionizable. आता याच्यामध्ये जो सोल्यूट आपण ऍड केला आहे तो नॉन होलाटाईल आहे. द युरिया और सुक्रोज और ग्लुकोज नॉन होलाटाईलचे एक्झाम्पल्स. म्हणजे सोल्यूट आपण युरिया ऍड करू शकतो, सुक्रोज ऍड करू शकतो किंवा ग्लुकोज, यापैकी कोणता तरी एक सोल्यूट आपण या सोल्युशन मध्ये ऍड केलेला आहे. द वेपर प्रेशर विल बी प्रेझेंट ऑन ओनली द मॉलेक्युल्स प्रेझेंट ऑन द सरफेस विच विल बी इव्हॅपोरेट. दॅट मीन्स अवर सॉल्व्हंट मॉलेक्युल दे आर होलाटाईल, सो द वेपर प्रेशर प्रेझेंट ओनली ऑन द सॉल्व्हंट मॉलेक्युल. अवर सोल्युट इज नॉन होलाटाईल, नॉन होलाटाईल आहे त्यामुळे त्याचे वेपर्स क्रिएट होणार आहेत का? नाही, इव्हॅपोरेटच होणार नाही, वेपर क्रिएट होणार नाहीत, त्यामुळे त्याच्यावरती कोणतंही वेपर प्रेशर नसणार आहे. इफ वी कम्पेअरिंग द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ दीज टू सोल्युशन अँड द सॉल्व्हंट हॅव्हिंग हायर वेपर प्रेशर एज अ कम्पेअर टू द सोल्युशन दॅट सॉल्व्हंट. डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट. इन जनरल एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑब्झर्वेशन इज दॅट द फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट ऑफ अ सॉल्व्हंट इज लोअर्ड बाय डिझॉल्व्हिंग नॉन होलाटाईल सोल्यूट इन टू इट. दस द फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट ऑफ अ सोल्युशन कंटेनिंग नॉन होलाटाईल सोल्यूट इज लोअर दॅन दॅट ऑफ अ प्युअर सॉल्व्हंट. प्युअर सॉल्व्हंट पेक्षा जर आपण फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट सोल्युशनचा कम्पेअर केला, इट इज लोअर दॅन दॅट ऑफ अ प्युअर सॉल्व्हंट. If we take the TF naught is the freezing point of a pure solvent and TF be the TF is the freezing point of solution. Into that solution we add a non-volatile solute. That solute is dissolved into that. The value of TF naught is greater than that of a TF. The difference between freezing point of a pure solvent and that of the solution is a depression in a freezing point. The value of the depression in a freezing point, that means delta TF is equal to the greater value minus smaller value. Delta Tf is equal to Tf naught minus Tf. That means freezing point of a pure solvent minus freezing point of a solution. From this video, we understand in a very simple manner the freezing point of that substance. Here, we take a solution of solvent and a non-volatile solute. If that solute and a solvent, that means that a liquid and a solid are in equilibrium, then that time it will be freeze. जर आपण जर सॉल्वंट बघितला, जर आपण वॉटर सॉल्वंट घेतला तर तो इजीली फ्रीज होऊ शकतो, परंतु त्या वॉटर मध्ये आपण काय ऍड केलंय, अ नॉन होलाटाईल सोल्यूट ऍड केलंय, आणि तो सोल्यूट ऍड केल्यानंतर त्याला फ्रीज करायचं असेल तर त्याचा फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट काय होणार आहे, इट विल बी लेस एज अ कम्पेअर टू दॅट ऑफ अ प्युअर सॉल्वंट. इफ वी ऍड अ नॉन होलाटाईल सोल्यूट into that, then the temperature of that solution goes on decreases. See here, on the right side, it is our pure solvent. That means if we consider that solvent is as a water, then the freezing point of that water is a 0 degree Celsius. See here, at a 0 degree Celsius, that water will be freeze. But if we add a solute into this solution, then the temperature of that solution goes on decreases below that of a 0 degree. See here, that the temperature will be reduces. That means from 0 degree Celsius, it will be reduce or a decrease up to minus 2 degree Celsius. From these to understand, the freezing point of the pure solvent is greater than that of a freezing point of the solution. सोल्यूट ऍड केल्यामुळे काय झालं, त्याचा फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट 0 degree पासून आणखीन कमी झाला, मायनस 2 degree Celsius पर्यंत लो झाला. अकॉर्डिंग टू रोल्स लॉ, द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सॉल्वंट इज ग्रेटर दॅन दॅट ऑफ अ वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सोल्युशन. हिअर पी वन नॉट बी द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द प्युअर सॉल्वंट is greater than that of our vapor pressure of a solution, that means P1. Now, from this graph, we understand how the freezing point will be depressed. See here, the pink colored graph is our liquid solvent. The faint blue colored is our solution graph. Firstly, see these two. Compare these two. Then, the solute which is added into that solvent is less volatile. जर समजा तो less volatile असेल, म्हणजे अगदी little quantity मध्ये त्याचे vapors तयार झाले, तर तो evaporate अगदी लेस टेम्परेचरला. हा छोटा जो कर्व खाली दिसतोय तो आपला सोल्यूटचा असणार आहे, तो कोणत्या फेज मध्ये, सॉलिड फेज मध्ये. नाव ए बी इज द सॉल्वंट, बी सी इज अवर अ सोल्यूट, अँड ई डी बी अवर अ सोल्युशन कर्व. इफ ड्रॉ अ डॉटेड लाईन फ्रॉम दॅट पॉइंट बी, दॅट मीन्स द टेम्परेचर ऍट विच अवर अ सॉल्वंट विल बी फ्रीज इज द Tf naught. Pure solvent, therefore we write a Pf naught. From the E, the solution, from the solution we draw the dotted line, that is the freezing point of our solution, that means Tf. If we comparing these two, the value of Tf naught is greater as compared to the Tf, therefore the difference between these two is our delta Tf. Freezing point depression as a consequence of a vapor pressure lowering. From this graph, we easily understand vapor pressure लोअरिंगशी कम्पेअर करून आपण फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट डिप्रेशन बघितलं. इथे सुद्धा आपल्याला तीन कर्व दिसत आहेत, बी ए बी सी हियर सी डी अँड ई एफ. ए बी फॉर अ सॉलिड सॉल्व्हंट, हियर अ सी डी फॉर अ लिक्विड सॉल्व्हंट अँड ई एफ शोज द कर्व ऑफ सोल्युशन. टी नॉट इज द टेम्परेचर फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द लिक्विड सॉल्व्हंट, वाइल टी इज द फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सोल्युशन. द टेम्परेचर करस्पॉन्डिंग बी इज द फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट ऑफ अ सॉल्व्हंट. फ्रॉम द बी इफ वी ड्रॉ द डॉटेड लाईन, दॅट इज फॉर द सॉल्व्हंट. अँड टी एफ टेम्परेचर करस्पॉन्डिंग पॉइंट ई, सी हियर फ्रॉम ई इफ वी draw the dotted line from that E, that temperature is the freezing point of our solution. Now one question will be comes here, why freezing point of a solvent is lowered by dissolving non-volatile solute in it? Non-volatile solute jeva ta dissolve hoto tar freezing point kami ka hoto? At the freezing point of a pure liquid, the attractive force among the molecule are larger to cause the change of a phase from liquid to solid. If we compare only the solvent into the liquid phase, the force of attraction is greater as compared to when we add a solute into that. Liquid, solid, phase change zali. Tyamule tatla force of attraction kay honar hai? Reduce honar hai. Thus, in the solution, the solvent molecule are separated from each other because the solute molecule, thus the separation of a solvent molecule is a solution is more than that of a pure solvent. This results in decreasing the attractive force between solvent molecule. Consequently, the temperature of the solution is lowered below the freezing point of a solvent to cause the phase change when or a liquid is converted into the solid. That solid phase change झाली आहे, म्हणजेच त्यामध्ये काय होणार आहे, सोल्युशन च जे फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट आहे तो काय होणार आहे, रिड्यूस होणार आहे एज कम्पेअर टू द प्युअर सॉल्व्हंट. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज फ्रीझिंग पॉइंट डिप्रेशन अँड अ कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ सोल्यूट. इट हॅज बीन शोन एक्सपेरिमेंटली that the depression of a freezing point is directly proportional to the molality of the solution. If we compare that point with the boiling point, that the delta TB value is also directly proportional to the molality. Similar to that, the freezing point is also directly proportional to that of a molality. Here, if we write the equation, then the value of delta Tf is equal to Kf into m. Kf be the freezing point depression constant. That constant is also known as the cryoscopic constant. Apan jo Kb baghitla hota boiling point elevation madhe, tala apan kay mhanat hoto ebullioscopic constant. Itha suddha Kf ha constant ghetlela aahe, tya constant la apan cryoscopic constant asa mhannar aahe. If we put the value of a molality is 1, that means value of m is equal to 1, then in that equation the value of m becomes 1, therefore these two are equal, the cryoscopic constant. Thus the depression in freezing point produced by one molar solution of the non-volatile solute, see here the value of delta Tf is equal to the Kf, both values become same. Depression of a freezing point is equal to the cryoscopic constant. From this, if we find out the unit of that cryoscopic constant is a Kelvin kilogram mole inverse, or that temperature we will write into the degree Celsius. Kelvin as well as degree Celsius, degree Celsius kg mole inverse. Now molar mass of a solute from freezing point depression. How to find out the molar mass of the solute? Delta Tf is equal to Kf into m. From this equation, the molality of the solution is given by the value of m. In a previous lecture, we calculate how the value of m. From that, see here, the value of m is equal to 1000 W2 upon M2 W1. If we put the value of that m into the above equation, substituting the value of m in equation delta Tf is equal to K of m, we get that the delta Tf is equal to Kf into, we put the value of m here, 1000 W2 M2 W1. From these, the value of M2 means molar mass of a solute. If we take molar mass at the left side, the equation we are getting, that means molar mass of a solute is equal to 1000 Kf into W2 upon delta Tf W1. By using these formula, we find out the molar mass of the solute. आता फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट डिप्रेशन वरून जर आपल्याला एखाद्या सोल्यूटचा मोलार मास काढायचा असेल तर आपण M2 इज इक्वल टू 1000 Kf W2 अपॉन डेल्टा Tf W1 या फॉर्म्युलानी काढू शकतो. नाउ सम ऍप्लिकेशन्स फॉर फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट डिप्रेशन. कीपिंग द रोड्स आईस फ्री इन विंटर. इन सम कंट्रीज द आईस विल बी फॉल्स ऑन द रोड्स. दिस फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट डिप्रेशन प्रॉपर्टी इज यूज्ड for keeping the roads ice free. Also in the homemade ice cream, this property is used. In cars, adding antifreeze to that car, this property is used. Now next, last one colligative property of non-electrolyte solution is osmotic pressure. That osmotic pressure phenomenon involves the use of semi-permeable membrane. But what is mean semi-permeable membrane? That semi-permeable membrane which allows only solvent molecule to pass through it, not a solute particle. What is mean a semi-permeable membrane? In between the solvent and a solute, the frame is present, a film is present. That film only allow the solvent particle from that, not the solute into that. आता समजा जर आपण एका साइडला एका कंटेनर मध्ये वॉटर एका साइडला घेतले आणि एका साइडला आपण वॉटर प्लस शुगर घेतले, म्हणजे शुगर सोल्युशन घेतले, तर त्या शुगर सोल्युशन मध्ये असणारं जे वॉटर आहे तेच फक्त या सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन मधून पास होणार आहे. त्यामध्ये ऍड केलेलं सोल्युट काय आहे? शुगर. दॅट कॅनॉट बी पास फ्रॉम दीज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन. इट इज अ फिल्म विच हॅज अ पोर लार दो टू अलाव द सॉल्वंट मॉलिक्युल टू पास थ्रू देम द स्मॉल इन अ दो नॉट टू अलाव द पॅसेज ऑफ अ लार्ज सोल्युट मॉलिक्युल और आयन्स of a higher molecular mass through them. त्याच्यातून फक्त सॉल्वंट, जे स्मॉल साईजचे सॉल्वंट आहेत तेच फक्त पास होणार आहे, सोल्युट पास होणार नाहीत. असं जे मेम्ब्रेन आहे त्याला आपण सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन असणार आहे. फॉर एक्झाम्पल सेल्युलोज, दीज ऑल दी एक्झाम्पल्स ऑफ द सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन. नाउ ऑस्मोसिस, व्हॉट इज मीन ऑस्मोसिस? We see the osmotic pressure later, but firstly understand what is mean the osmosis. From this figure, if we consider the first one, the semi-permeable membrane is present between solvent and solution. In first figure, the solvent will be passes from this solution. जर आपण सोल्युशन आणि सॉल्वंट कम्पेअर केले तर सॉल्वंट मध्ये सॉल्वंट जास्त असणार आहे ॲज अ कम्पेअर टू द सोल्युशन. सोल्युशन मध्ये सोल्युट पण आहे आणि सॉल्वंट पण आहे, म्हणजे नंबर ऑफ सोल्युट अँड सॉल्वंट आर प्रेझेंट इन अ सोल्युशन. बट इन केस ऑफ द सॉल्वंट, प्युअर सॉल्वंट इज प्रेझेंट, ऑल आर द सॉल्वंट. देअरफोर द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द सॉल्वंट इज अ ग्रेटर इन दीज पार्ट ॲज अ कम्पेअर टू दॅट ऑफ अ सोल्युशन. आणि आपल्याला माहितच आहे हायर कडून लोअर कडे फ्लो असतो, देअरफोर द नेट फ्लो ऑफ अ सॉल्वंट इज इन दीज डायरेक्शन, हायर टू लोअर, ग्रेटर टू लोअर. when the solution and the pure solvent are two different solutions having different concentrations are separated by semi-permeable membrane, the rate of passage of solvent molecules into the solution or from more dilute solution to more concentrated solution is found to be a greater than the rate is a reverse direction. This is the favorable since the vapor pressure of a solvent is greater than that of a solution. In the second, we take and a solution, both are the solutions, but one is the diluted solution and one will be the concentrated solution. The lower concentrated solution moves, see here, the higher concentrated solution. आता लोअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड आहे म्हणजेच त्यामध्ये सोल्यूट कमी असणार आहे, सॉल्वंट जास्त असणार आहे. हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड आहे म्हणजे त्याच्यात सोल्यूट जास्त असणार आहे आणि सॉल्वंट म्हणजे ऍज कम्पेअर टू द लोअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन. मग इकडे काय होणार आहे, हायर टू लोअर. पण इथं सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन मधून फ्लो कशाचा होतो, फक्त सॉल्वंटचा होतो. म्हणजे या पहिल्या सोल्युशन मध्ये सॉल्वंट जास्त आहे आणि दुसऱ्यामध्ये ऍज अ कम्पेअर टू द फर्स्ट वन सोल्यूट जास्त आहे. मग फ्लो सॉल्वंटचा होतो, देअरफोर द नेट फ्लो ऑफ अ सॉल्वंट इन दीज डायरेक्शन, द नेट स्पॉन्टेनियस फ्लो ऑफ अ सॉल्वंट मॉलिक्युल इन टू द सोल्युशन और फ्रॉम मोर डायल्यूट सोल्युशन टू मोर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड सोल्युशन थ्रू अ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज कॉल्ड एज अ ऑस्मॉसिस. Most important definition, osmosis. As a result of osmosis, the amount of a liquid on the pure solvent side or a more dilute solution side decreases and on the other side increases. This result in a decrease of the concentration of the solution. See here what happened when that solvent moves towards this higher concentrated solution. इकडे सॉल्वंट जास्त होता, दुसऱ्यामध्ये सोल्यूट जास्त होता, काय होणार आहे, फ्लो सॉल्वंटचा इन दीज डायरेक्शन, लोअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन टू द हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन. मग हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन सोल्युशन मध्ये गेल्यावर काय होणार आहे, सॉल्वंट इन्क्रीज होणार आहे. सॉल्वंट इन्क्रीज झाला म्हणजेच त्याचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन काय होणार आहे, कमी होणार आहे. इन द सेकंड वी अंडरस्टँड सिंपली नॉर्मल ऑस्मॉसिस इज गिवन हियर, लोअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड. इन द लोअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड सोल्युशन सॉल्वंट इज मोर, द ब्ल्यू कलर्ड इज अवर सॉल्वंट, येलो कलर्ड डॉट आर दी सोल्यूट. हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन आहे, सोल्यूट जास्त आहे, लोअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन आहे, सोल्यूट कमी आहे. जर आपण हे सोल्युशन या दोन्हींमध्ये जर सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन आहे म्हटलं तर यातला जो सॉल्वंट आहे तो या हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन कडे. सी हियर द लेवल ऑफ दॅट वॉटर, ब्ल्यू कलर आपला वॉटर आहे असं समजूत आणि त्यामध्ये हा सोल्यूट ऍड केलाय, तर काय होणार आहे, फ्लो ऑफ दॅट वॉटर टुवर्ड्स दी हायर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन. देअरफोर द रेंज, सी हियर द रेंज ऑफ दॅट वॉटर विल बी इन्क्रीजेस. नाव द नेक्स्ट इज osmotic pressure. This osmotic pressure can be demonstrated by the experimental setup. See here in that figure, from that we understand how the osmotic pressure will be given here. In a beaker the water is present, into that the inverted Thistle tube is present, and into that tube the sugar solution is placed. That sugar solution having higher concentration as compared to that of a water. Then some of the solvent passes through this membrane into the solution. It causes the liquid level of this tube goes on increases. The liquid column is in the tube create, that is our hydrostatic pressure that pushes the solvent back through a membrane into the container. The column of liquid in the tube continues to rise, the equivalent stop of rising. At this stage hydrostatic pressure develops, the specific force solvent molecule back through the membrane into the container. See here, from this container An equilibrium is thus established where rates of a forward and the reverse passage are equal. The height of the liquid column in the tube remains constant. This impulse is that hydrostatic pressure has a stopped osmosis. In simple words, here in a beaker, we take a water into that tube, we add a sugar solution. The solvent, that means water, will be passes from these semi-permeable membrane into the tube. But the hydrostatic pressure will be applied from the upward direction on that solute. And the pressure, hydrostatic pressure and the outer pressure, both are into the equilibrium. Then the process osmosis will be stopped. That pressure is known as a osmotic pressure. The hydrostatic pressure that stops osmosis is an osmotic pressure denoted by pi. The hydrostatic pressure is equal to the h rho g. Here h is the height of that liquid present into this column. Rho is the density of the solution and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Now there are three types depending upon the concentration of the solute and solvent: isotonic, hypertonic and a hypotonic solution. First, what is mean the isotonic solution? Two or more solution exerted the same osmotic pressure is called as a isotonic solution. That means both have same osmotic pressure. If solutions are separated by semi-permeable membrane, there is a no flow of a solvent in a either direction. See here, one example is given. 0.1 molar urea solution and a 0.1 molar sucrose solution are isotonic because the osmotic pressure of urea and osmotic pressure of sucrose both are equal. Such solutions having same molar concentration but a different concentration in a gram per liter, if these solutions are separated by semi-permeable membrane, then the solution cannot be flows towards the sucrose solution because both have a same osmotic pressure. The next point will be the hypertonic solution. If two solutions have unequal osmotic pressure, isotonic means both have a same osmotic pressure. Hypertonic means both solutions cannot have a equal osmotic pressure. The more concentrated solution with a higher osmotic pressure is said to be hypertonic solution. And if two solution have unequal osmotic pressure, more dilute solution exhibiting lower osmotic pressure is said to be hypotonic solution. Hypertonic, that means more concentrated solution. Hypotonic means more diluted solution. For example, if the osmotic pressure of a sucrose solution is higher than that of a urea solution, the sucrose solution is a hypertonic, while the urea solution is hypotonic to sucrose solution. From these all example, we understand the isotonic solution, hypertonic solution and a hypotonic solution. Here we complete the three types of a solution. Now the next point is the osmotic pressure and a concentration of a solution. If we are taking very diluted solution, the osmotic pressure follows the equation, that means pi is equal to N2 RT divided by V. Here V be the volume of a solution in a DM cube. That solution containing N2 moles of a non-volatile solute, and R be the gas constant, which is equal to the value of that R is a 0.08206 dm cube atmosphere Kelvin inverse, mole inverse, and pi is the osmotic pressure in a atmosphere. the term N2 by V, here the term N2 by V is the concentration of molarity. If we put the value of N2 divided by V as a m, then we get the equation. This equation becomes pi is equal to mRT. Solute concentration is expressed in a molarity, while calculated osmotic pressure rather than molality. The reason is that osmotic pressure measured are the reason is that osmotic pressure measurement are made at a specific constant temperature. It is not necessary to express concentration in the temperature independent unit like a molality. Now, here also we find out the molar mass of a solute from the osmotic pressure. What is the equation of the osmotic pressure? Osmotic pressure, that means pi is equal to N2 RT divided by V. Here we take the W2 grams of a solute, that means W2 is the mass of a solute which is dissolved into the V liters of the solution. M be the molar mass, then the number of moles of a solute is given by N is equal to W2 upon M2. If we put the value of N in the above equation, then we get pi is equal to, that means osmotic pressure is equal to W2 RT divided by M2 V. Here M2 be the molar mass of a solute. Therefore, we take that M2 on a left side, the equation to find out the molar mass of a solute, we get M2 is equal to W2 RT upon pi V. These all about the colligative properties of non-electrolyte solutions. Thank you.